concerns it. Because the CII summit and the committee, which I'll talk about a little later, has been relentlessly working in this area, and I'll talk a little about it a little later. In fact, let me cover it now. This is the committee which I have the honor of chairing, and we have members who are from small, large, and medium companies who are very committed to the cause and what we're trying to achieve. We have done certain initiatives which I will talk about gradually, but what I notice, I've chaired a lot of committees in my life in CII. Something that I noticed that is amazing, putting us together and doing new things with the committee. You know, CII has a direct membership of 8,000 plus companies. So that's our first target audience. Of course, we want to spread this to non-CII members also. But our first target audience is the CII membership. Then if you look at the associations of CII, then there could probably be 2 lakh members or something like that. It's really huge, except in the ever-competing business environment. And with the globalization, competition has become fiercer and fiercer. So it's making it more challenging, and it is becoming absolutely necessary to remain on the right side of the law. The reported cases of corruption and scandals, which we had our share of it recently, have not only been a cause of concern for the regulators and the government, but also a challenge for the business ecosystem. There is a need to focus on the relevance of ethical and fair business practices and maintaining the highest standards of integrity and transparency in running a business. This is of paramount importance. Ethics is the intent to follow the law in true letter and spirit. Therefore, to uphold and preserve the spirit of governance, the drive has to come from companies, the management, the boards, and every individual. The aftermath of the unethical behavior can cause significant reputation and financial risks for a company. That's not good for the country either. Obviously, emphasizing on both ethics and compliance is imperative for business and obviously for the country. It is widely accepted that corruption, be it corporate or political, petty or large, has become a worldwide challenge. This acceptance is acknowledged by a host of international conventions the world over. In parallel, corporate scandals across the globe have been instrumental in bringing corporate governance to the forefront of the business landscape. And this is an area which the present government is very determined, and the present government has done a lot of work in this area, and we've seen a significant change since the current government has been in power. Going back to the scandals that have shaken investor confidence and spurned governance reforms in the past decade. Unfortunately, while jurisdictions across the globe have tried to address the challenges posed by such scandals by suitably amending their corporate governance framework, the instances of misfeasances and misgovernance, transparency and integrity in governance are not something which regulators have to impose on management. It should come from within. A regulator is responsible for putting in place the requisite legal framework. However, it is the users and stakeholders who should ensure that it is complied with and all their actions fall within the scope of the regulatory framework.